This is Jon Schaffer from Iced Earth, and you are watching The Age of Metal.
Hello everyone, this is Miguel with The Age of Metal, and I'm here at Asylum Records in Tempe, Arizona with none other than Jon Schaffer of Iced Earth. How are you doing, sir?
I'm good. I bet you're going to get an amazing shot of the ceiling right there.
Now,
I'm just saying.
Gotcha. Now, this is the last stage of a 5-month long tour. It started in Europe. In January, February, South America, Australia, March and April, and now closing up April and May in North America, which has been so far the highlights of this cycle for Iced Earth?
That's difficult, man. We've gone to a lot of new territories on this tour, so there was some cool, like we played in Israel for the first time. That was cool. It was great. Fans were awesome, man. It was a really, we got to go to Jerusalem. We had a day off before the gig, mm-hmm. and we played in Tel Aviv, and we played in St. Petersburg, Russia for the first time, and a lot of Eastern European countries and some new countries in South America. So, it's been cool, tiring, mm-hmm. and it's actually more than 5 months because that's just our headline part of it. Mm-hmm. But we had a 2-month tour with Volbeat in Europe in October, November, and part of December, and then we went home for a few weeks for Christmas and immediately went back to Europe and started doing pre-production for the headline tour. So it's been, and then basically you had festivals before that, the recording, and it's been a heavy three and a half years. It's really been pretty intense. We've done lots of shows, 300
You lost
some.
The count already.
That's pushing 350, and, and in 3 years, 2 studio albums and a DVD, and, 350 or so live shows, I think, something like that. So it's a lot. It's a lot of work.
Well, I mean, with this headlining tour, 5 months is a lot. But besides that, you were saying since October, it's also more time. Plus, you guys being in the road. What do you guys do in order to keep you guys, sane? And, in the meantime, in the downtime, in the meantime that you guys have waiting till showtime, to keep yourself, healthy, busier, or at least relaxed?
Well, that time's coming. There really hasn't been a lot of that. I mean, we've been going full steam ahead really since summer of 2011 when we did our last shows with Matt, and then we're already recording Dystopia in that period. And so there was a lot of flying back and forth between Europe and it's just been, but the time's coming. I mean, once we do have festivals in Europe this summer, so we have a few weeks after we wrap up in Oklahoma City of downtime, and then we get back together and do a day or two of rehearsal, and we start some festivals. I think we've got 3 or 4 trips across the Atlantic this summer. But then after, in September is really when the band's taking a break.
Okay. So
it'll be, and we have things on the schedule for later in the year, and then in spring next year. So there is stuff happening, but we will have some time to spend with our families and try to regain our sanity, what little is left.
That's good. That's good to hear that you guys are looking forward for that time. Definitely looking forward for tonight. Iced Earth since when you guys toured with Volbeat a couple years back. Now, talking about Plagues of Babylon, the new album, how the fans have received this album in comparison with Dystopia?
Great. I mean, I can't complain about either. They're both very strong records, and the fan base seems to be very happy with things. And you know, Iced Earth is blessed, man, with a very passionate fan base, and it has been for many years now. So it's like it's a really very very cool thing and a cool relationship, and they seem to be pretty pumped up. You know, it doesn't matter. That's why I'm saying, what's the highlight? It's hard to say. I mean, obviously, whenever Iced Earth goes to Greece, that's a special thing, because there's a special bond there. I don't know why. Never really been able to figure it out, but ever since the band started, there's been this fire, you know, and passion from the Greek people. But we have that everywhere. It's just that they're really so over the top, you know.
I hear the Greeks love their power metal a lot. So.
They love Iced Earth. I can tell you that. Yeah, they love metal, but Iced Earth is kind of like a religion there. So it's pretty awesome. I mean, especially with as tough as their economy has been, and you know, the things I've seen, the big changes in the last 4 or 5 years, and it's just horrible. Mm-hmm. What's happening to the people and how much they're suffering, but they still manage to come to the shows, and I think it's a big outlet for them. You know. So.
Well, that's good to hear. Now. Technically, what happened on Plagues of Babylon that didn't happen on Dystopia?
I mean, we recorded in Germany, mm-hmm. so that was different. It was a whole different, I produced the record. It was a whole different kind of a system. I've never done an album totally in the box. Mm-hmm. So that was a little bit foreign and a little bit of a challenge working with analog to digital converters that I wasn't used to and really didn't like, just put it being straight. But I mean, you know, we definitely made the best. I think the album in the end sounds great. That's the most important thing. But it was a lot of challenges to get to that point. And but still, you know, it was really because of our touring schedule in the summer and all the festivals that we had to do. And I didn't want to fly back and forth every weekend like I did on Dystopia from Europe to the States. I mean, that's really tiring. It's a long, long trip, and you know, you're always in a state of jet lag when it's like that. And that's not the way to be working in the studio. So we found a place where we could house everybody in the studio. Everybody was on site, which was really cool because I could schedule the guys out and, you know, grab them whenever I needed them and get their parts going, and when people would get tired, I'd just get somebody else to come in and start working with them, and it worked out really well in that respect. So, it was different. It was kind of sucked not working with Jim, because, you know, he's my man, he's one of my brothers, and my, he's my daughter's godfather. I mean, we're really close, so we always had a lot of fun when we're working together, but it just didn't work out, and Iced Earth had a schedule. A lot of it hinging upon the Volbeat tour in Europe, which was a huge opportunity for us because they're giant there.
Yes.
And, they had sold out arenas everywhere. And those last 20 shows were arena shows, and, you know, 12, 15, 20,000 people a night. So it was a really big opportunity for us to get exposure to a different audience. And so we really had to, like, design the schedule to fit with a release that would coincide with that. And the album itself didn't come out until after that, but we had the Plagues EP, and you know, we were pushing the new material on our set that we did. So you know, it was a lot of things hinged on all that, and we had a schedule, we had to stick to it. But I think it was overall, the album came out great, and I really liked the fact that we were able to do a few different masters. So people that like vinyl and they have a good sounding system, they can hear that this album actually was mastered for vinyl. And it makes a big difference and very dynamic. So, you know, those are some of the really cool points about this album.
Well, that's great. Definitely the album, it goes to the top. It syncs with Dystopia perfectly. Mm. And definitely the subjects are amazing. And actually, that was my next question. Hansi worked on vocals. He was guest on the song Among the Living.
Yep.
But besides that, do you guys get the chance to talk about the next Demon and Wizards? Because I know everyone asks you this, but it's a topic that people is wanting to hear.
Well, of course, we talk about it, you know, and we are going to do it. But the problem is, you know, Thieves and Wizards has been so successful that we've set a standard, and we have to adhere to that. We have to match it or surpass it, hopefully surpass it.
Definitely.
And that doesn't happen just like with holes in between the schedule over the course of a couple of years. And our schedules never line up. That's the tricky part. In order to do a Demons and Wizards record properly, I think we need a year. You know, we need a year to write, to rehearse and record and produce, and then to go out and tour because there's such a demand for it. So I don't want to do it. I don't want to do it halfway. Mm-hmm. And Hansi doesn't either. And, you know, it's just one of those things that if it was a new project that nobody's heard before, we could probably piecemeal it together when we have a chance, but we've really raised the bar. You know, the Demons records are so popular still. It's been about 10 years since the first, or since the second one came out, and the requests are unbelievable for it. I mean, it's all the time, and we both get bombarded with this, and we you know, we do it. It isn't about the money. It's about our friendship, the fact that we can write songs together that are cool and that touch people. And
it's fucking epic.
Yeah, I mean, it's just, it's really a matter of time. And I, you know, my band has been working really hard. I can't just say, okay, guys, you know, we've been busting our balls for 3 years. Now I need to take a year off to do Demons and Wizards. Mm-hmm. You know, it's one of those things that Hansi and I are we'll always do this for as long as we're alive. It may be really long times between the albums, but there's definitely going to be more. That's not a question. It's just a question of when and keeping the standard up to where, you know, we both want it to be.
Awesome. That's great to hear. Ice Earth features a new man behind the drums. His name is Raphael Saini. How he ended up in Ice Earth?
Well, he was also a fill-in drummer, just like he's not in anymore. He did the recording and part of the Bull Beat tour, and now John Deddy is with us as a fill-in drummer. He came in for the back half of the Wolvie tour and for this much so far. So we're, you know, Brent had to step down because of personal problems. And, you know, we love Brent and we miss him. And, you know, that's a whole nother issue. But right now we don't have a permanent position in the drum, you know, in the drum position. We're just kind of looking. And, you know, John's committed up through the U.S. tour. And we've got a couple other guys in mind for the summer. And hopefully we're going to find that guy. You know, but right now it's, you know, we're feeling our way out. And the four of us, the other, you know, Luke and Stu, Troy and I have really bonded. We've been through a lot of stuff in the last few years and a lot of traveling, you know what I mean? Like it's your relationship can either really grow apart or get stronger. And we need to find that special guy that really fits in with us on a personal level as a musical level. And those sometimes are two very different things. But I'm very appreciative for Raf and for John being able to step in kind of last minute situations and help us get through recording and through, you know, the touring that we've done so far.
Well, that's good to hear, and I'm definitely looking forward to the new drummer on of Ice Earth later on, hopefully.
It'll be good, whoever it is, that's for sure. You can count on it.
Has to be good. Almost a year ago, it was released the live DVD, Live in Asian Kuron, and how has been the response of the DVD? Regardless, that is not on 1080p. That I understand it was an issue with that.
Yeah, I was really disappointed because in our contract, that's what they were supposed to provide as the camera crew, and of course we're the day in the heat of the moment, and they show up with some inferior equipment. I mean, the fans still love it. You know, it's just one of those things for me. It was very frustrating. And I mean, the crew did not listen to our director, and our director was there for a specific reason. And because of the nature of the amphitheater that we were at, you know, it's, I think that current version of it's 2,000 years old. That place has been a theater for gladiatorial events and theater in, you know, the Greek, Roman, and Byzantine empires. I mean, it's like 6,000 years old, the site. So it's amazing. I mean, but that being said, you know, the challenges that the crew faced just to make the show happen was already a challenge. And then, you know, the film guy showed up, and we didn't really have like a truck where our director could sit and radios. He had to actually go from camera to camera, and the guys didn't listen to his direction to begin with. So there was a lot of shots that I think it could have been better had people provided the gear and listened. But I think, you know, we made the best of it, and it was certainly a, I wouldn't take it back for anything, because it was such a historical, cool place to be, you know.
Yeah, and it's a landmark.
It really is, because it's never going to happen again. The Cypriot government said never again. Oh. It's not that our fans hurt the place, but I think the promoter got the permit. I don't think they realized what was going on. And then after, you know, a heavy metal show like that happens, I think it really, if you have something like that happen too often, the vibrations alone are going to do some damage to the place like that. So, you know.
Well, I mean, definitely in 720, it looks amazing anyway. It's just breathtaking. Ice Air played last year India for the first time at the Bangalore Open Air. How was the experience, and how the Indian crowd react to the material of Ice Earth?
The fans were great, and we were supposed to do it the year before, I believe, or maybe it was 2 years before.
And it got canceled?
It got canceled because we couldn't get our visas. Mm-hmm. Anybody, because we have a very international band and crew, and it was the Americans all got denied. I don't know what happened, but something happened. And the other guys in the band and crew, you know, if they had different passports, they were able to get theirs, but it was, you know, it just turned into a last minute sort of a mess, which actually for me actually turned out to be cool, because I got to see Roger Waters do the Wall live.
Nice.
So that was awesome. But no, I felt bad for the fans, but we were able to make it up to them when we did it. And, you know, it was, they're great. Very passionate audience. Yeah. There's a lot of dedicated Iced Earth fans there, just like, you know, the bands played in China, and we played in New Zealand, and we played all these places around the world. And I mean, you got a passionate fan base, man. There we go.
Definitely.
It's really cool.
It's a strong fan base, one of the strongest I ever seen, besides Maiden and Metallica, probably.
Yeah, and that's good company to be in. You know what I'm saying? That's like, if we sold 10% of the records those guys do, then it would be awesome. But, you know, no, it's really cool to have that kind of a spirit and passion as a fan base. You can't ask for anything more.
Well, finally, and closing up, what is next for Ice Earth after this North American tour? I understand it's like, you know, at least 5 dates or 15 dates left, and then some summer festivals, and then what is after that?
Just time off for a while. I mean, the band and crew are pretty exhausted, so it's kind of reached that point, you know. We have some plans to do some recording at the end of the year. Not a new studio album, but something special that we're planning. And then we have dates confirmed for, I think, April or May next year. But there's always stuff coming in. So it could be that, you know, later in the year we get an offer to be a support band. And if it makes sense, then we'll go out and do it. But I mean, I'm actually having another cervical fusion, another neck surgery that's happening in September. So that's kind of reached the point where it absolutely has to happen, and that's going to take me, you know, 6 weeks or something to heal up from that. And after that, we'll see, man. I mean, you know, if the right tour comes along. But as far as us going out and doing, you know, this has been, we've done a lot, you know, in the last few years, and I think it's actually a good time for us all to take a breather so we don't burn ourselves out, and we can come back recharged and ready to kill. And like I said, next year, there's already a lot of plans starting in spring of next year. So
that's good to hear. Well, John, definitely looking forward tonight for the new songs, for the new material of Ice Earth. Definitely is always a pleasure, and it's always a breathtaking show. Cool. I've seen you guys at Club Nokia in LA last year at the Marquee here. 2 years ago at the Marquee here, and definitely just blew my mind. Definitely looking forward for tonight for the new songs, for the new album.
Cool,
and well, thank you very much for taking the time to talk about with us and share some stuff about Plagues of Babylon. And definitely, well, looking forward for tonight.
All right, man. Sounds cool. Take care.
See you, man.